There was this one time in junior high when I came up to you and sat next to you in the library. And I had this crossword puzzle, and I just started filling it out with random letters, pretending I knew all the answers, trying to make you think I was some kind of crossword puzzle genius.
I have no recollection of that. Why didn't you just say something to me?
You know, there must be a good reason. I can't quite recall what it would be. Oh, that's right. I was terrified.
Ah, I see. Well, it was high school. I had my share of killer crushes back then, too.
Yeah, the only difference being, all you had to do was walk up to the guy in question and say, I'm Carol Vesey. I have a crush on you. Begin dating me now.
Yeah, right, exactly, because I am Carol Vesey, and everything in my life turns out just exactly as I planned.
I can't believe I'm going to do this. I'm about to say something which could ruin what has been up to now a near-perfect date.
Near-perfect.
I thought the onion loaf was a little soggy.
What?
Why are you out here with me if you're in love with Nick Stanton?
I don't want to talk about Nick Stanton.
Talk about Nick Nolte?
Huh?
Was that off limits, too? I thought he was fabulous in Prince of Tides.
Yes. Yes, he was good. Hello. What's this?
I just thought of makeup the other night.
Mm-hmm. Shouldn't you be reading about scurvy or something?
Mm-hmm. Scurvy can wait. By the way, great chicken, honey.
I'll show you great chicken.
Nice double entendre.
Mm-hmm. I'll show you a nice double entendre. Okay.
Yeah, honey.
Honey, are you okay?
Oh, yeah, no, I'm just concentrating on the kissing stuff.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Good morning. I can't see you, Sarah. Peek-a-boo, there you are.
Well, Carol Vesey, I guess this is good night.
Yeah, yeah. Thanks for dinner.
Thanks for not ordering an appetizer. Are you crying? Why are you crying? You could have had an appetizer.
You are very, very nice.
I apologize.
Ed.
Yes.
What went wrong in your marriage?
Well, I was so good in bed. I was so skillful in the art of lovemaking that my wife just couldn't handle it. Poor woman was in over her head. It was sad, really.
I see.
You're not buying that.
No, no.
My wife, Liz, has three tiny little freckles on her cheek right here. And when we went on our first date, I nicknamed them Mo, Larry, and Curly. And when she would smile, she would get this really big dimple, and Larry would just plump disappear. So instead of ever asking, how are you, I would always ask, how's Larry? You know, sometimes two people can fall so completely in love and yet be so completely wrong for one another. Fate's nasty side, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ed.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to come inside?
I can't.
Oh. Oh, no, because that's fine.
No, because, Carol, I can't help but think that you and I are on a double date here. You know?
Oh, yeah, yeah. How do you think Nick and Liz are getting along about now?
Yeah. Good night, Carol Vesey. on second thought. Maybe we're overthinking this thing. You know what? Maybe I should just come right in.
Yeah, but you know what? Actually, Ed, I think you're right. This is just a mistake.
No, right. No, you're right. Yeah, I was right. We were right.
You're right.
Good.
Right.